Chamillionaire was once one of the premier artists coming out of Houston, making a number one hit on the Hot 100 Billboard chart and two top 10 albums on the Billboard 200. Of course, that was at a time when there was a magnifying glass on Houston. Any and everybody was getting some type of shine as the big machines were tapping into the underground scene that Houston had built over the past decade. And Chamillionaire was the only act from that cluster to win a Grammy. But long before that, he was making a name for himself with the Color Changer Click, alongside the likes of his brother Razak, 50-50 Twin, and Lou Hawk, but most notably, of course, Pow Wow, which the two became the face of the click that released the regional smash hit, In Love With My Money, from the debut project Get Your Mind Correct.
I'm in love with my foreign, yes, I'm married to my dog. I'm in love with my money.
He also gained significant ground in the underground with the mixtape Messiah series that spanned from 2004 to 2009, dropping 7 mixtapes, with the first being the most bought mixtape in Texas history, according to Wikipedia. But since then, what's happened to Chamillionaire? Is he riding dirty? Or is he creating so much generational wealth that he is truly producing what is the sound of revenge? The internet puts Chamillionaire's net worth anywhere between $28 and $60 million. And that's definitely not from record sales, right? Even though his song Riding did amass 3.2 million ringtone sales and was the best-selling ringtone in history at that time, but even ringtones can't produce that type of net worth. Chamillionaire is what's known in the finance world as an angel investor. An angel investor is a high net worth individual who provides financial backing for small startups or entrepreneurs, typically in exchange for ownership equity in the company. So basically, he gets in early on shit that eventually blows up and makes a ton of money, like the home security company he invested in called Ring. Heard of that, right? And the rideshare company that's the competition of Uber called Lyft. Heard of that one too. His focus is to get people that look like him a seat at the table and bring exposure to other ways to make money, which he describes as a lot less risky than being in the music business.
Lately, I've been having a lot of conversations with peers from the music industry that want to break into the world of tech and investing. And one thing I noticed that's a common trend is every time we're talking about investing, someone will always mention how risky it is. Now, I'm not going to sit here and act like there aren't risks associated with investing, but I find it to be ironic because as long as I was running around the music industry, I don't recall ever hearing someone say that something was risky. I'm just saying, if you were to put $50,000 worth of jewelry on your neck and walk around with it, no one would really tell you that's risky. If you were to spend a couple $100,000 on a vehicle and drive around the city in it, no one would really tell you that was risky. You could drop a mixtape, dissing another rapper, walk into a strip club with a pocket full of money, throw it all in the air, walk into the parking lot, see people shooting at each other, and the next night when we're headed to the next club, no one would stop and say, wait a second, this is risky. So basically it's about reformatting the way we think about things because we're all investors in some form of fashion. The clothes you wore to the club, the jewelry you bought to impress other people, the rims you put on your vehicle, your iPhone, all of that is an investment. It's just some investments don't make us back any money in return. There will always be risks associated with investing. It's just that some investments lead to a dead end and some might lead to a pot of gold. You just have to remember the rule of thumb is when you're investing, you only spend what you can afford to lose because that's far less risky than being a rapper.
Musically, we haven't heard from Chamillionaire in a while, although he did make an appearance on Big Pokey's Sensei album in 2021, and he still sounds like he haven't missed a beat. But other than that, he's been pretty much silent. But hey, can you blame him? It's Hype South for Child Time TV. Until next time, peace.